Hey there, how you doing? Charlie Winters here with selections for Tuesday the 18th of July. But first, a quick recap on Monday's performance. Well, it was a profitable day. Hey, and like the comments say, yes, we was unlucky. We could have had, and I'll go through it now. Right, Josie Bond ran okay. I thought it was going to end up out the placings, but kept on for third or maybe fourth. Manila Scouse. I think we're actually unlucky with that horse. As you can see, I got 9-2 because I put mine on in the early hours of the morning, and it halved in price on 9-1. It's clear what happened with that one. Apparently, and I think it was only for that race, there was a strong headwind, and apparently it didn't benefit the horses that ran up with the pace. And as you're well aware, everything was swamped with the furlong to go because I thought we'd got the winner. So that might be worth actually keep an eye on for next time. It basically just stopped with a furlong to go, and a lot of them did, and then a lot of them came from behind, and obviously it came out the placings. Well, that was probably my most fancied horse. Then the third selection is Honor Your Dreams. Well, that horse, it doubled in price. Well, doubled in price from what the price I took. I took 11-2. I saw 10-1, and it should have won. Let's be honest, but. When I saw the price, I thought, "Hey, well, that's not trying today." Dollbooks should have won 18-1. I think it was it 22s or 25s the night before. Then Air Poet dobbed on the line. It's like, what's going on? So I end up having a 10p each way Canadian in the end because I noticed that I didn't quite give so much money away by losing the oddments on the bet. So I don't know how you got on, but I think it was roughly about 3 or 4 times the stake returned today. So I'm going to click close and let me stop waffling and get into Tuesday's bet. So let's minimise some of these. Right, I think it's totalling £7.50. But the reason why I've gone for that is because I've rounded it down to a tenner that's left in my account. So no real method behind it. So I've had a 10p each way lucky 15, 15p each way doubles, 25p each way singles, and just to round it up to £7.50 is a 35p each way fourfold. I like the look of these, but I'm not ecstatic. I think that there's good angles towards them, and I've gone for big prices, and that's why I've had a 25p each way singles on them as well. So here we go. The first selection is 50 cent at 8-1 in the 3:10 at Beverley, paying 4 places instead of 3. This can occasionally pull hard, but also it seems to stay on quite well. Well, I think there's either 3 or 4 front runners, and like regular front runners. So if they go tearing off, they might help stop this horse from pulling hard because it's a good pace. And hopefully it can obviously overtake them towards the finish and hang on. Well, it's not always as easy as that, but I hope it is. It's a poor race. There's a lot of poor racing at Beverley today, Tuesday. And I think they could set the race up for this kind of horse or even the ones behind it. But I'm going for this horse because it's the best in the best horse in the race, and I think it'll handle the softer ground. The second selection is Arnie Angel at 20-1 in the 3:45 at Beverley, paying 5 places instead of 3. It's shown little glimpses of form, but not a great deal. I find it interesting that Phil Dennis, I think he rides it for the third time now. Last time it had no chance because, as you're well aware, regular viewers of the channel will realise that Red Car, when it's good ground, they tend to go, or when it's slower ground, they tend to go to the far side. Well, I think it was good ground when this horse last ran, but I think it was drawn 17. Well, it was drawn right towards the opposite rail. But according to the commentary, the minute it came out the stalls, it went right up to the far side. It would have lost absolute miles. So I think it's worth taking, like, giving another chance. And at 20-1, which it probably will get bigger, to be fair, I think it's worth small stakes. The third selection is Turbo Tiger at 33-1 in the 420 at Beverly, paying four places instead of three. And it's another one I'm going to give another chance to. This is the horse that I described that is the fastest horse I've seen go round the bend. And it nearly ended up in the car park going round the bend. Then it completely stopped. It's been given a bit of time off. I think this relatively straight, I think it's 5 furlongs, may actually suit it. And it may take quite a few horses off the feet. Will they be able to come back to Turbo Tiger? Well, more than likely so. But I think it could give a few of the horses a bit of a scare. So I think 33-1 is too big a price to ignore. The fourth selection is First Grade at 22-1 in the 525 at Beverly, paying four places instead of three. This one loves soft ground, although it's been out of form. I think it's trained by Michael Dodds. The horse, according to its Racing Post ratings, is gradually improving this season, as in, like, basically it started off at being dreadful and it's been not quite as dreadful. So hopefully this time it runs a decent race, and it's becoming well handicapped, and it, especially based on its soft ground performances when it won last season. So I think it's got every chance, and 22-1, in my opinion, is too big. So I think that horse, or this horse, is apparently there's showers forecast as well, so it's not going to quicken from soft ground. So I do believe First Grade could be a much shorter price. I think it could be below 12-1 tomorrow possibly. So the very best of luck. You give me a like and subscribe, or even a comment, I really appreciate it. So the very best of luck. Charlie Winters, over and out. Cheers, mate.